unusual hat. I wonder what's under a hat such as that. It could be the creature they call the gazette, who balances things on his head because it's flat, or a stripe-loving pipester from Upper Mount Bat, or a sort of a kind of a hat wearing... cat!
I can see you got quite a mind for your age. Why, one dink, and you dragged me right onto the stage. Now that I'm here, there is no telling what may ensue. With a cat such as me, and a thinker like you. Oh, the things you can think, oh, the things you can think, if you're willing to try. Think invisible ink, or a gink with a stink, or a stare to the sky. If you open your mind, oh, the things you will find, lining up to get loose. Oh, the things you can think when you think about Seuss!
Trip on a ship to the Vipper of Hip, or to Salisaloo.
Think a beautiful slop
with a cherry on top.
You don't need an excuse.
Oh, the things you can think
when you think about Seuss. Going on adventure down a dangerous trail.
Ah! Think of a bird who flies off on a spree.
Think of a kangaroo, sad as can be.
Think of some monkeys with trouble in store.
Think of something horrible and hairy, something sinister and scary that you never dared to think of before. Think of nobody here and the feeling of fear and the darkness of night. In your room, as you're facing your doom,
think a glimmer of light.
Ah!
But I hope you're prepared to be scareder than scared,
cause this ain't Mother Goose.
Danger's right on the brink
when you think about Seuss. Seuss, 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 Seuss.
An unusual story will soon be unfurled of an elephant trying to save a small world. And a boy from that world who has think, just like you.
Think!
And the smallest of small,
to the jungle a newel,
and the largest of all.
You think and 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 think. Just think! Oh, the things you can think. Think and wonder and dream far and wide as you dare. When your things have run dry, in the blink of an eye, there's another thing there.
Strange sound, the drums of a jungle beginning to pound. Now imagine a sky.
I'll imagine bright blue.
It's the jungle of Noor
near the river Waloo.
Think of an elephant lumbering through.
say, how confusing. I've never heard tell of a small speck of dust that is able to yell. So you know what I think? I think there must be someone on top of that small speck of dust. Some poor little person who's shaking with fear that'll blow in the pool. He has no way to steer. He's alone in the universe. I'll just have to save him because, after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
What a what a what a
so gently, and using the greatest of care, the elephant stretched his great trunk.
Oh, Better look out, better look out, Horton. Better look out, or someone's gonna get your quota. Better look out, better look out, Horton. Better look out, better look out.
On the 15th of May, Miss Gertrude McVice discovered how truly unique Horton was, but she knew
again, calling over and over.
Help!
So he tried to think who might be down on that clover. An invisible world, amazing but true. And guess who now enters the story?
Who?
You.
Hello? Who's hello? Is anyone there? Who are you?
We're who's here. We are who's here. Smaller than the eye can see. It's true, sir. We're who's.
So are we.
We're tiny little people floating by in the air, wondering how and why.
We're on who? The tiniest planet in the sky.
La la la, hoo hoo. La 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 la, hoo hoo.
La 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 la, hoo hoo. La la la.
We're who's here, win or lose here, struggling.
Thank you.
tiny Who family on a small rainy day.
Mom and Dad are just home from the Who PTA.
He was Mommy's little boy. He was Daddy's little man.
He was never any trouble till this stinking thing began.
We must both lay down the law.
Will he hate us?
Maybe so.
Oh, where are the instructions on how to raise a child? Who has the instructions on how to raise a child? Who has all the answers? I don't know.
Jojo! I'm the mayor of Who. Why, I've just been elected, and upright behavior is thus forth expected.
We've just had a talk with your teachers today, and they didn't have one single good thing to say.
You invented new things which defy all description.
You gave Miss O'Doley a nervous conniption.
Your things were so wild they disrupted your classes. They made Mrs. McElhoo drop her new glasses, and that's why you're suspended.
Yes, that's what they said.
Young man, what and who has got into your head? Now Horton has found us. We're safe on the clover, but clearly our troubles are far, far from over.
We don't mean to scold you. We love you. Oh, yes, dear. But couldn't you try thinking just a bit less, dear?
Stop telling such outlandish tales.
Stop turning minnows into whales.
Now take your bath and go to bed.
And think some normal things instead.
You got me in trouble. Get out. Go away.
All right, I'll go. But first, let me say... Oh, the things you can think.
Stop.
Oh, the things you can think.
Be quiet.
As you splash and you splish.
I'm not listening.
As you sit there and scrub. Have a think in that tub. Think of water and fish.
Fish?
Think of pipes on the floor. Leading off to the shore. Where the water is cool. Soon your tub's not a tub.
It's McElligot's pool. This might be a pool like I've read of in books. Connected to one of those underground brooks. An underground river that searches and flows. Right under this bathtub, and then who knows? It's possible. Anything's possible. Singing out clothes, it's possible. Anything's possible.
It's possible. Anything's possible.
This might be a river now, mightn't it be? Connecting McElligot's pool with the sea. Then maybe some fish might be swimming, swimming toward me.
It's possible.
possible. It's possible. Anything, anything.
Jojo! The tub's overflowed on the floor. Water is running right under the door.
The ceiling is peeling. You've flooded the den.
Oh, Jojo, I think you've been thinking again. I say this with firmness and terrible sorrow. Young man, we will deal with you come tomorrow.
Well, I still think that I'm not such a fool as I sit here and fish. Gallagher's pool.
It's possible. Anything's possible.
For over a week, getting laughed at for thinking a dust speck can speak. Well, let them all laugh. I'll try not to mind, for I have found something that they'll never find. There are secrets on a leaf, in the water, in the air, hidden planets, tiny worlds, on this earth. Not a person seems to know, not a person seems to care. There's no one who believes a thing I say. Well, I'm fairly certain at one time or other, great thinkers all feel this way. Double.
Sometimes my thinks are what get me in trouble.
When you think, do you dream?
in bright colors.
Me too. And I go to strange places like Seussical.
When you dream, do you dream that you could fly to the stars?
Little friend, no one else could have things such as ours.
Yes, I have wings.
I have wings.
And I can fly.
I can fly.
Around the moon and far beyond the sky. And one day soon, I know there you'll be. One small voice in the universe.
One true friend in the universe.
Good night, JoJo.
Good night, Horton. I'll see you in Seussical.
Wake up!
The scene's over. There's more to be heard. There goes our hero. Who enters?
The bird.
Love song for Horton, number 4. 137.
Do 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 do. There once was a girl bird named Gertrude. Smallest plain tail ever was. One droopy droop feather, that's all that she had. And oh, that one feather made Gertrude so sad. She curled it, she tied it, she gave it a puff. She decked it with flowers, but it wasn't enough. For no matter what, it just was what it was. A tail that simply wasn't meant to catch the eye of an elephant. The one feather tail of Miss Gertrude McFuzz.
A sorry sight. I'm gonna take you under my wing, and baby, you'll be alright. I was once a plain little bird like you, kid. One pathetic feather was all I grew. I had nothing show-off-ish. What's a plain bird to do? And there's certainly nothing show-offish on you.
Thank you, Maisie.
Then I made a plan for my self-improvement. No more crumbs, I vowed I would have the cake. Yes, I went to the doctor.
Doctor, take my leg.
And he told me what sort of a pill I should take. Now
whistling
at me now.
Amazing Maisie.
Maybe that's my
the doctor, the doctor named Egg, whose office was high in a tree by the lake, and she cried, "Mr. Doctor, oh please, you know, I'm some sort of pill that will make my tail grow."
"Tut, tut," said the doctor, "such talk is too absurd. Your little tail is just right for your kind of bird."
Then Gertrude had tantrum, she raised such a din that finally the doctor just had to give in.
"All right already, bring in the pillberry bush."
Gulp. Gulp. Gulp.
What was that? Something's itching me. What was that? Something's twitching me. What was that? Are those feathers I see? I think my tail's beginning. Oh my word, this is wonderful. Second, third, wow, I'm colorful. What a bird I'm beginning to be.
Amazing Gertrude, just look at that tail, she's fortunate. Amazing Gertrude,
thank you, Dr. Dink.
Thanks, Dr. Amazing Gertrude,
and hopefully I'll impress Horton.
Amazing Gertrude,
one more pill will do me good, yes it will. One more, one more, one more pill.
Soon she'll have the biggest tail. She'll have the biggest tail.
I'll have the biggest tail.
She'll have the biggest tail of all.
Now Gertrude is happy. Her tail's nice and long.
Kid, fasten your seatbelt, because things are about to go wrong.
One heck of a drive. We've got monkeys backed up to the 302.
I'd find alternative routes if I were you.
Then over the desert of trees, and into the forest with thousands of trees, past beaches on beaches,
and sour kangaroos.
We're born to the elephant, chasing the hoos, chasing the hoos.
Chasing your dust, quiet, safe as can be.
We're monkeys to trust, why don't you agree?
And just to be sure, we're handing it off
to a black-bottom eagle named
Loud Lavakoff.
Somewhere inside of a great patch of clovers 100 miles wide. I'll find it or bust. Well, I shall find my friends on their small speck of dust. Yes, clover by clover by clover with care, I'll listen and call. Are you there? Are you there?
It's taken all my courage to approach you, not to mention all my stamina to follow you across those deserts. But I feel as if I'm ready to confess to you my feelings that I've hidden with great diligence and labor. Behind the facade, your odd little next door neighbor. My eyes are too small, I have very large feet, and I'm not very proud of my pitiful tweet. But I've now got a tail that is something to see.
102, 103.
Oh, notice me, Horton, feather by feather. This is your next door neighbor calling. Notice me, Horton, Horton together. We could be great. The clover. This is your next door neighbor calling. There's a new leaf. Your neighbor's turned over.
It's hopeless.
You said it, kid.
Who's there?
It's me, Maisie, up here.
Maisie, are you on a nest?
Yeah, you want to make an of it?
No, I just never thought I'd see you on a nest.
Neither did I, Hort, neither did I. Just a girl on the wing. When I met Tweed McFirst, oh, could that night owl sing? Tell yourself how lucky you are. We spent 3 weeks of bliss, then the usual say. Tired, sitting day after day. Who knew so much work was required? I'd much rather play. I need a vacation. I'm due for some rest. Hey, Horton, would you maybe like to sit on my nest?
Why, Maisie, I couldn't, of all silly things. I haven't got feathers. I haven't got wings. And not only that, but I'm here on a search. I just can leave my poor who's in the lurch.
I won't be gone long, kid. I give you my word. I'll hurry right back, cause I'm that sort of bird. Oh, Horton, I promise I'll fly back real soon. I'll only be gone for, say, one afternoon.
Well, we all need vacations. All right, go on, take it. I'll sit on your egg and I'll try not to break it. But please come back quickly, 1 hour, maybe two. I need to find JoJo. I've got to save who?
Hit it, Cat. Thanks. Thanks a million. So long, Toodoo.
So carefully, tenderly, gently he crept up the trunk.
Hello.
I'm a cat in the hat. Yes, I'm wearing an unusually striped hat. And I came to tell you that I'll be in quite a huff. I beg you, go out and buy our stuff. While I take a break to go fishing, you take a brief intermission.
Have now your seat and sit in now sought, because hold on everyone, there's still quite a lot. Welcome and hello and cheerio and all that. Greetings everyone and come in for the second act.
To the elephants, egg nest and tree, egg nest and tree, egg nest and tree. They loaded the wagon right onto a ship out over the ocean, and ooh, what a trip! Rolling and tossing and sick as can be. Just a seasick elephant.
Gentlemen, and welcome to Seussical. Our first I'm up to bid this evening is a penderless pachyderm on egg, nest, and tree. Our bidding will begin at $10,000. Do I hear a 10? 10,000? 10,000, okay, we're ready. Starting off at 10,000 again. Let's go with that. You with the blue Seuss shirt. Thank you for breaking the fourth wall. You know you want this elephant. There's nothing better in this world than this elephant. 3,000 for 3,000 to the Seuss. 100,000, 200,000, 20, 20, a million? 100? 20 billion? Come on, we can do better than that. I can't hear you. $3 billion? All this money? 25,000? Going once? Going twice? Sold to the Mayor of Cybers and the greasy black mustache. Excuse me, madam. Sold instead to the man from the circus.
The world's greatest show.
on the face of the earth, or wherever you go.
A circus? I love a show. I think I'll go. Good gracious. I've seen you before. Now, let's see.
Why, Maisie, it's Horton. Remember, it's me. Sat on your egg now for 51 weeks. I've sat here while people have paid to take peeks. I've sat here through hailstorms and lightning and snow. Won't you take back your egg?
Gee, I really don't know. Oh, wow, it's really late. And gee, I've got a date. And lots of places to be, but it's so great to see you. Look at you. Who would ever guess? Look at you. Such a big success. And it's all thanks to me. Amazing Horton, that exiting circus sensation. Amazing Horton, even I'm impressed. Amazing Horton, well, I was off taking vacation. You made your fortune up on Maisie's neck. I may be unreliable, fancy free, irresponsible, crazy me, always eager to fly. But seeing you gives me true delight. Just for once, I've done something right. The egg is all yours. No, don't thank me. I'll cry. Good luck when it hatches. Good luck and goodbye.
I meant what I said. And I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful 100%. And now, little egg, you're alone in the universe too. Who would have thought you'd be left up to me? A fool of an elephant up in a tree. This time I swear I'll do better than try. I'll protect you from harm. Yes, I'll do it or die. So rest now, young egg, and I'll sing you a lullaby.
Sala, Salu, Sala, Salu.
and my friend Jojo too. I hope they all made it to Sol Salou.
High on a mountain or lost on the sea, sooner or later I'll find it.
I have a picture of how it will be.
I'll bet you forgot about Gertrude McFuzz. Well, that's nothing new. I mean, everyone does. But Gertrude did something that few birds could do. So this is the tale of Miss Gertrude, part two. Psst. Horton! Horton, are you there?
What is it?
It's me, Gertrude! Horton, oh Horton, are you all right? I was so worried.
Gertrude, how did you find us?
Well, it's a long story. I had a little trouble because I grew a little tail. Well, it wasn't really little, it was absolutely giant, and it really was attractive, but you never even noticed, so I felt a little silly even trying. Besides which, the tail was too heavy for normal flying. So I ran to the doctor.
The doctor named Dake, and she said,
my tail has been a mistake.
And she said,
Dr. Dake, I've been foolish and vain. Pluck it out, get it off. I won't do it again.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ouch, it hurt a lot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ooh, a tender spot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Just a one feather tail.
Then suddenly, Gertrude could sail.
I sailed on a junk and was practically sunk for you. I trampled through the trees full of furious bees for you. I slogged through a fog and a choking bog down a soggy slope through a stinky bog while my slip was gripped by a vicious dog for you. And I couldn't, and I haven't gone through. I sprained my little toe, and I hobbled like so for you.
For you.
Then came the hit and run, but I staggered on one for you.
For you.
Now here I am, the worse for wear, and here you are. I'm here. You're there. And one more thing. It took me 7 weeks, but I found your clover to you.
artist. You're amazing.
Yes. Oh, it was nothing.
Hello? Who's hello? Is anyone there?
Hello.
Oh, what a relief. Why, hello, Mr. Mayor. Is JoJo all right?
Hi, Horton.
Oh, JoJo, hello. Kid, now that I've got you, I won't let you go. I'll shelter and guard you because, after all, a person's a person, no matter how small.
A person's a person, no matter how.
How did you get here?
You're gonna be going in style. We're talking to a spread and sitting on an egg. You're gonna be put on trial.
This is the case of the people versus Horton the Elephant.
Horton the Elephant.
On an egg.
Your Honor, this culprit exhibit A. There who's here, there are who's here, smaller than the eye can see.
He's like fool in jungle at all.
It's true, sir, here's who's, sir, he's a who and so is she.
He's like fool in jungle at all. Talking to his back, to his back and death.
Objection! Overruled!
Sit on an egg.
Objection!
I meant what I said, and I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful 100%. You can throw me in your jail, lock me up in a zoo, but I won't desert my egg, and I will not abandon these who's, sir, win or lose, sir, whether you believe or not. They're here, they live in fear, and I'm the only friend they've got. You can do what you want with me, Your Honor, and I won't question why. But please save who? The tiniest minute in the sky.
Based on the evidence, I have no choice but to order the defendant, Horton the Elephant, remanded to the Newell Asylum for the criminally insane.
And as for that dust bag,
ooh, that dust bag.
As for your dust bag,
ooh, that speck.
And as for your dust bag,
you will boil. Hot steamy kettle of bees will not boil.
Prove it to you. Mr. Mayor, oh please, Mr. Mayor, you've got to prove now that you really are there. So ring every doorbell and send out the word. Make every who holler, make every who hurt.
Boil.
Attention all who's, we've got to be heard.
There's no time to lose.
So send up a shout.
Make it loud and clear.
Person's a person.
person, no matter how small. And you very small persons will not have to die if you make yourselves heard. So please try.
Boil it! Boil it!
For a moment, young Jojo looked grim. The fate of the Who's rested squarely on him. But then came a thing, a peculiar new word, the kind of a word no one ever had heard.
Boil it! Boil it! Boil it!
Stop!
Do you hear what I hear? Do you see what I mean? They made themselves heard, though they still can't be seen.
They've proved they're persons, no matter how small.
And their whole world was saved by the smallest of all.
How true, yes, how true, said the sour kangaroo. And from now on, you know what I'm going to do? From now on, I'm going to protect them with you. And the young kangaroo in her pouch said,
me too.
Pebbles were ended. They hailed this great yacht. And Jojo was honored as thinker nonstop. And all Jojo's things would forever be heard, including this thing.
Sings.
Gertrude, what will I do? I am slow, I'm fat, all I know is the earth. He'll need much more than that.
Open your mind.
on, both on stage and off, we would like to thank Miss Elizabeth Young for everything that she's done for this production. And most importantly, we'd like to wish her a happy birthday.